How are we doing tonight? I want to do a real quick review on the Eaton FRX2. This is my AM, FM, and weather band handheld radio. It's a pretty cool little gadget. There's some functions that are built into it that work really well. There are some functions that are built into it that do not work very well. And I'll try and cover those here as quickly as I can. It comes with a lanyard, comes with a USB cord to where you can plug it into a computer, a power block, say the one you use for your cell phone, that sort of thing. On the bottom, here are your plugs. So you've got your earphone jack, your power jack, and then a USB jack. The USB jack is to dump power from the battery in the radio into your cell phone. My first experience with this was not very good when I first got it. That's one reason I was kind of attracted to buy this, was as a backup to recharge my cell phone. So the first time I got it, I brought it in, I charged it up. My cell phone was actually about to die, so I let it die. So I plugged it in, and after the radio was charged, I let it sit for a couple hours. And to be honest with you, it did not really charge the cell phone that well. However, a little test here. The battery in the Eaton is fully charged right now. So I'll plug the cell phone in. All right, and you have to go to the dial and then turn the dial to cell. And there we go. So it does get a little bit of a charge out of it. Maybe you'd be able to place a call, you know, send a text, that sort of thing. You're not going to get a full cell phone charge off of this little battery. It may come through in a pinch, though. Alright, other functions in this cool little toy are, this is a solar panel, and to be honest with you, the solar panel does not really work all that great. I've tried it. I don't know, you can't really tell, but it's not going to make a big difference. Here's your antenna for your radio. Here is a charging handle to where you can turn it. And you can power the battery that way. This actually does work pretty good. You got to spend some time cranking on it, but you can definitely get, you know, some power into the battery by doing that. Also, there is three LED flashlight up on top. And another cool function here is this white rim is glow in the dark. So if you drop it and it's dark outside, you're in a tent, the basement, outside, whatever, that makes it easy to find. Alright, now for the radio. Just grab the antenna, pull that out, and we'll turn the power on.
Jack Cooley was a man, Tom Knight. You know, it's a great win for us, you know, we're on the road, it seems like, for a month.
There's the AM. There's the FM.
225 miles an hour. Rome.
And the weather band radio.
51 degrees. Wind south at 16 miles an hour. Chattanooga. It was mostly cloudy.
So the radio on this does work really well. So it can be a valuable source of information, especially when you are out in the woods, on the trails, that sort of thing. This can be invaluable. If you're in a car, you got a car radio. You know, if you're in a car that doesn't have a car radio, then it's definitely nice to have something like this around. The battery in it is not going to last too long. You can, if you don't use it, you leave it fully charged in your camping box. It'll probably, or your camping bag, whatever, glove box. It'll last for, you know, several weeks. I wouldn't push it out to a month as far as lasting unused with a charge in the battery. That's going to eventually die down. The dial on the radio is extremely sensitive. So it's kind of tricky to dial in certain stations and that sort of thing, but you know, it's possible. In a pinch, it'll do. What this radio is good for is for, you know, natural disasters, hurricanes, tornadoes, those sorts of things. You know, if you need somewhere where information is not readily accessible and you need to get a, you know, public service announcement or, you know, the news or, of course, weatherband radio, this is a great little tool to have. I've actually used it out on the fishing boat before, and you know, it's been pretty good as far as being able to dial in and get the weather information that I was looking for. What you don't want to use this for, this is not a radio that you're going to take with you to the beach or the pool and listen to for half an afternoon. It's not meant for that. It's not built for that. The battery is not going to last that long. If that's the type of radio you're looking for, then this is not the product you want to get. But if you're looking for a cool little survival tool, something that's, you know, small, compact, can kind of fit in with, you know, some other extremely small, lightweight type gear, this is a good addition to your kit. So if you have any experience with this and you know, you'd like to leave a comment, something I didn't mention, let me know. If not, I hope you enjoyed the video and please subscribe. Have a great night. Take care. Bye.
Feeling so much better, I can cakewalk in the town.